Far too often, people in the lesbian, gay, bisexual, trans, and queer community are targets of hate, discrimination, and backlash. Corporations and small businesses alike have had to invest in sensitivity training to deal with LGBTQ members who were isolated and treated differently because of their preference. Major League Baseball has been no exception. Back in the 1970s and 80s, professional baseball teams were not quite equipped to handle this type of workplace issue, nor were they ready for Glenn Burke. Burke became the first openly gay professional athlete in this country, but it came at a cost. The Los Angeles Dodgers drafted the outfielder in 1976. Burke played in 225 games in his four seasons in the major league. He had 523 at-bats with a .237 average. The Dodgers traded Burke to the Oakland A's, and he believed they did so because of his sexual orientation. They often avoided talking to him, isolated him, and made him feel unwanted. During Burke's time in the league, acceptance of the LGBTQ community was uncommon. The A's shipped him to the minor leagues, and in a matter of months, they released him as well. Glenn Burke never played Major League Baseball again. Sadly, he died in 1995 from AIDS. Since then, Major League Baseball has strengthened the zero-tolerance policy against discrimination, including bias based on sexual orientation. Those policies weren't in place or enforced during Glenn Burke's Major League Baseball career, but he should receive credit for his courage when acceptance of people like him was not the norm.